Today we'll talk about the 3D text feature that is now available in Unreal Engine. Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to askNK. So this is going to be a quick one, and it has to do with a question that was asked earlier prior to the video which we did, that has to do with modeling in Unreal Engine 4.25, and it has to do with the 3D text that we talked about. And at the same time, we did make an announcement about this owing to the preview version that was released. So right now there is a preview 2 of the Unreal Engine 4.25, and how you work with 3D text is extremely simple. So you can choose to go over to edit and go to plugins, or you can simply go over from here, settings, and go over to the plugins. Now with this open, you can simply type the word text. So if I go through and type the word text, you would need to activate the text 3D and restart your Unreal Engine. So once you restart that, you would be able to find this around here. So what you need to do is, you know, instead of simply going through and trying to get these things right here, what you can do is you can go over to the section called All Classes and simply type the word text. So if I come through and type the word text, I can easily bring out the text 3D and drop it here. So one thing to note is that the text 3D first made its appearance in Unreal Engine 4.24. So what I'm going to do next is just simply click and drag and drop directly here. And you can see the text tool simply applies, and you can, you know, bring in as much as you want, totally dependent on what you want to create. So in case you're trying to label stuff, you just want to get the text directly here for pre-visualization, for your film, for your animation, you can simply do all of those things directly here. Now, if you come over to the details section, which has to do with the attributes that you can work with, you'll be able to change the text. So we can go over and just simply type the word Unreal. So I can just go ahead and type the word Unreal, press enter directly there, and you'll be able to see that we have that right here. You can choose to extrude this. So once you go in and type and press enter, you might be able to get that happening, but by simply, you know, using the slider, in most cases that doesn't work. So with this here, I'm also going to press F on the keyboard just to zoom right in. I'm also going to do that one more time. And yes, so we have this right here. So with this here, the next thing which you might want to play with, especially if you're trying to get into working with the text here, is the bevels. So there is now bevels here, which is sweet and pretty easy to work with. And I can choose to make this a half circle or a linear bevel. And if I make it a linear bevel, you can already start noticing what we're getting, and we can choose to play with the segments that we want. All right, so if you want to see your edges, especially when you're doing your bevels, like right now we have our bevel set to 2 already, and I actually went ahead to tone this down to 1. If we go over to show and go all the way down to where we have advanced, and scroll down to where we have mesh edges, we'll be able to see the mesh edges. For some reason, I've actually come to see that if you go in and put in a number here or a value there, you actually don't see that happening here. So by default, when you're doing your bevels, if you add a couple of bevel segments, you're supposed to have way more bevel segments, but I don't see that happening in this case. So I would go ahead and turn that to 0, and you can actually see what we have. So pretty cool stuff. You can still choose to play with the materials, you know, you can still choose to switch the materials. I can change the material that we have for the front to a given material, possibly a material that is, you know, exists with this template that we just used. And for the bevel, I can also switch over and select another given material, possibly another given material like the brush metal. So you can use this to actually go through and beautify the model itself or the text, and you can actually go ahead and have fun doing these things. You can also change the fonts. These are the number of fonts you have access to. Right now, the font library is not that heavy, as the font by default does not read your native fonts. So your native fonts are not read here. Unreal Engine actually has a font asset pack that you can use and have fun working with that. And if you're working with a couple of words, you can choose to align them to left, center, and right. You can also choose to work with vertical alignment, which is also something pretty cool. And it's good to see that there is kerning. So you can kern your text and you can see that. So in case you're into typography and you're trying to make some very interesting looking stuff, you can use the kerning to get that going. I'm also going to go back and set this to 0. And for line spacing, if you have a couple of words you've done, you can also use this. And for word spacing, so if we go through and say Unreal is awesome, for example, so if we do something like that, let's also go ahead and, you know, change the size, because I think the scale is a little bit too much. So I'm just going to get it to something like that. Press F to zoom right in. Yeah, so we can also choose to use, you know, the spacing, the word spacing, to actually space the words that we have. So you can use this to space the words. So these are just pretty interesting things that you can do with this. And I would really like to know what you guys think about this in the comment section. The bevel thing is still yet to get there. And of course, you know, Blender has an awesome bevel right now. And in case you haven't seen that, link to that video is going to be in the description, so you can go through and check that out. Yeah, so this is definitely going to be about it. I would like to know what you guys think about this in the comment section. And of course, if you like this video or you learned something from it, you can go ahead and give it a like, and don't forget to, you know, share it with a friend. And if you're new here, it's going to be amazing for you to hit the subscribe button and also turn on notifications so that you don't miss the next video or the next update. And until I see you guys again with the tutorial update, Free Friday, Tutorial Tuesday, tips and tricks, things like this. Peace.